What's that sound? Must mean it's Thanksgiving. Happy Turkey Day, everybody. Welcome to your third favorite podcast.
Gobble, gobble.
Welcome back to the garage, everybody. We hope you're having a great time with family for Thanksgiving in a couple of days.
Uh-huh. Hope you're getting that meal prepped. Hope that you're, skipping some meals so you can...
stuff yourself.
eat as much as you want.
Speaking of stuffed, it's time for our first segment, which we call...
S that T!
Which, of course, JJ stands for Stuff That Turkey.
Yeah.
Here's how this game works. JJ and I have each picked 5 items to stuff into a turkey for each other. We are going to blindfold ourselves and reach into a turkey, feel around, and we have to guess for what is inside of the turkey. We will get 100 points towards our season-long competition for Matt's surprise at the end of the season. We've wrapped this in a towel so that it doesn't get all over my in-laws' garage. And also, not only will the winner get points for however many they get correct, the loser will have to eat a can of cranberry sauce throughout the rest of this episode. Okay, we're getting started here. We're going to go one at a time. JJ, no, don't slap it. You're going to get juices on me.
Josh est JJ's tea. With a calculator, his driver's license, a Pop-Tart, a porcelain zebra, and a copy of Michelle Obama's Becoming.
We're going to do these one at a time. Okay. So you're going to feel multiple things at a time, but only grab one.
Okay. All right. So can I go?
Shove your hands in there.
Oh, gosh. Oh.
Why don't we...
That sound is so bad. Okay. All right. So I've got my first... what on earth is this? Is it... Is this a? My guess is a gift card, unless I have to be more specific. But I'm gonna say gift card. Okay.
Give me that. Put it to the side.
All right. Now I just keep
reaching in.
Yeah. Ugh. Oh. Okay. I'm gonna.
the sounds here are hurting my ears.
Yeah, I know exactly what this is.
Uh oh.
Okay, let me see if I can remember how to get to Block, dude. This is a Texas Instruments. Is this a T? I'm going to say calculator because if I say specific and then you're like, well, it's actually T5, T9. You know.
Okay, you're going to need to get the exact number. It's too easy. I'm just kidding. Go ahead and put it to the side.
All right. What is? What? It. Ew. Wait a minute. Hold on. Can I smell? Can I smell the items?
No, you cannot.
Okay, this is a Pop-Tart. This is a Pop-Tart.
Okay, go ahead and put it to the side.
I think. That's my guess. It's a Pop-Tart.
Go ahead and put it to the side.
Specifically, probably the pumpkin spice one from... That's probably left over from that last episode. Is this a porcelain elephant or dinosaur? This is a porcelain, or is it a salt? I'm gonna say this is a porcelain dinosaur.
Put that to the side.
Is it in the other side?
Oh, good gracious! Don't touch the mic.
Oh, I didn't.
with the turkey.
What is this? Is this it? Is this this the item?
Feel around. You want to hold that up people to see?
Yeah. Is this a? Is this a book of some sort?
We're going to need you to be specific on what type of book.
On what type of a book? I have to do that by feeling? I can't.
Okay, just remember a couple episodes ago, you made me guess Halloween trivia.
Well, that's...
With
okay,
no,
all right, fine, whatever.
With
whatever.
No answers.
I'm going to say that this is a ripped in half cookbook, I guess.
Okay, jeez. Go ahead and put it down.
Or it's that... Okay. Barack Obama's, the Michelle Obama book that okay. I know you have.
Okay, set it down. Let me take your thing off so that you don't put turkey
all right.
guts.
All right, okay.
You were right. How did you get that? Okay, so you got 100 points for Michelle Obama's Becoming
Perfect.
Journal.
Perfect.
You got the Pop-Tart, and
great.
It was pumpkin spice.
Boom.
You got the Texas Instruments calculator.
Thank you.
You
Block dude.
You did not get, this is a zebra.
That is not okay.
Specifically,
all right.
That
I'm gonna say, let's give him 50 points for that because he guessed a porcelain animal.
Well, you didn't say that I bought it in Kenya, so. And this is not a gift card. This is my driver's license.
Well, okay, all right.
So what is that? You got 100, 200, 300, 350 points.
Hey.
All right, this is not boding well for me.
All right. Well, you grab yours. That T was sufficiently S'd.
JJ S'd Josh's T with a pack of gum, Turkish Delight, dried mango, a police baton, and his retainer.
Let's see what you got. I don't think there's any way that you're going to beat me.
I know. I am actually legitimately shocked by how well you did. I am not happy that I chose Michelle Obama's book. Okay, there's something long in here that looks like it's going through the chest, out the butthole. I will. This is like kind of heavy. What?
Careful.
What is it?
I don't know, Josh. I can't tell you.
Oh.
Come on.
Why are you backing up when I shake it?
I'm not.
This seems like it feels like some kind of workout thing. Oh. What is this? I'm.
What do you think? It's a shake weight?
No, I was gonna guess a shake weight.
Come on, Josh.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna guess some kind of, but it's like soft.
Come on,
it
Josh.
Seems like a wand. Oh. Is this your like police wand? My guess is the police wand that you own that you can hit people with that JJ bought on Amazon.
I okay, all right. All right,
I'm putting
say
it to
what
the
you
side.
Want.
Gotta find the hole. Okay, got something right here. Feels like, is this gonna shock me? Is anything you put in here gonna hurt me?
I don't know.
You know what this feels like? It feels like one of those gum wrappers, the like gum joke gum things that you pull on. Okay. I'm gonna. Oh, it's just a pack of gum.
Okay, all right. Is that your answer?
Yeah, it's a pack of gum.
Okay.
Yeah, and I'm ripping it apart to know that it's not gonna shock me. Is this a thing or is this part of the
turkey? Yeah, that's a thing.
Oh. I was like, am I grabbing like
the
heart?
I don't think you're gonna be able to guess that.
Oh, I dropped it.
You dropped it. Here, let me put it in your hand. It's in your. Oh. Okay, you got it?
Okay, it feels like squishy dice.
Squishy dice. Oh, okay. All right.
This feels like something that used to be alive to me.
Okay, hurry up.
I'm not intentionally trying to smell, but I can smell something.
It's probably the turkey.
Wait. It's fruity. I'm not intentionally.
Okay, well, hurry up,
okay,
Josh.
Okay, my guess is like, it's like fruity candy.
More specific than that.
My guess, did you chew on something? Is this like pre-chewed?
I can't tell you.
Okay, my guess is like, it's not. I know it's not shaped this way, but all I can think of is Mike and Ike's.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
That's a terrible guess.
Well, I said fruity. How many things have I? Three?
That's three.
All right, this is a rib that I know was already there. Okay. Oh.
Let me.
Okay, I got something. Is this a bone? This is a retainer, dude. Why did you put your retainer in here? What the heck? At first, I was like, wait, this is like the rib cage or the lung or whatever. And then I felt like where the teeth would go. I 100% got that one.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Maybe you did.
Wait, is there one more?
Yes.
Is this
That's it.
Why is it floppy?
All right, hurry up, Josh.
Okay.
You're taking forever.
Okay. My first thought was like beef jerky, but it's too slippery, and I know that's partially because of the pumpkin guts.
Pumpkin guts.
Pumpkin guts. The turkey guts. Thinking about the pumpkin.
You're living
episode.
In the past.
Living in the past. But you know what this feels like?
What?
It feels like dried fruit. Okay, well, I got to just go with whatever the most popular is. I think dried mangoes is probably like the most popular. I'm going to go with dried mangoes. Is that all five things?
That's all five things, right? That is.
Would you mind?
Wait, is that all five?
It's all
Yeah, that's
okay,
all five.
Would you mind taking on my blindfold?
Okay, so yeah. my retainer.
That is disgusting. How much would I have to pay you to put it in your mouth right now?
$30.
No, I would not. You're gonna get sick. You're gonna get salmonella.
A dried mango.
Okay.
Fruit stripes gum. A police baton.
Yes!
Which this was given to me. I did not purchase it myself.
Okay.
And I'd never use it. Okay. All right. And this is Turkish Delight that I got in Turkey.
I do remember you bought so much Turkish Delight that you thought people were going to enjoy and then you couldn't give it away.
I gave a lot of it away. All right. So
how much should I get?
You got 400.
So. That's called, well, not a clean sweep. Close to a clean sweep. 4 out of 5. That's, JJ, get that cranberry sauce. This means, JJ, I have not caught up to you. I'm now 50 points behind you in our season-long competition. But I'm closer, and you have to eat cranberry sauce the entire
closer,
time.
And you have to eat cranberry sauce the whole time.
Have you opened a can before? What a privileged life you've led that you've never had to open.
I have. I just haven't used this
can
old
of food.
Old can opener.
Go ahead and take your first bite before we move on. And you can eat it at your leisure, however fast you want. You're going to go big first bite?
I mean, I got to eat this whole can.
Yeah, we got plenty of time left. How is it?
Not great.
Okay, smell it.
It's not terrible, but this is like 800 calories in this can.
I will say.
And how much sugar? Oh my gosh, that's so much sugar.
You're going to have to work out later.
That's like.
You're going to have to ride the Peloton later.
That's like 180 grams of sugar. Oh my gosh.
Hot take here. I actually prefer canned cranberry sauce more than like the actual whole cranberry juices. What do you?
Well, I mean, I prefer not to eat it by itself out of a can. I don't mind it, but. Okay, let's just move on. I'll continue to eat this.
All right. Take a bite and explain our next segment, big boy, while I put up these pointeroonies.
Call me fat? Jeez, no. Josh. Okay. Well, no. Josh and I like to impersonate people, and we've played this game before. We're going to play it again. It's called 10 Second Impressions Thanksgiving Edition. So our friend, director, producer, Matt Torrey, is going to hand us two receptacles that have celebrities and things that they're doing. So, Josh, why don't you go first?
You want me to go first?
And then, of course, Matt's going to choose who had the best impression at the end.
Okay. Bradley Cooper. Same one as last time. We promised we didn't plan that. Oh, my gosh. Bradley Cooper reviewing their latest Netflix obsession.
Well, I just turned on Netflix the other day, and the Great British Baking Show has been uploading episodes, and I just said, I just want to sit here and look at you. I love the bald man and the tall, skinny one with the black hair.
Okay, all right.
I love the way they make marmalade.
That's sufficient.
Was that better than last? That was better than last Bradley Cooper's.
Okay.
Well, who'd you get?
I'm like from A Bug's Life. Buying a pumpkin spice latte. Oh, yeah, I would like to have a venti pumpkin spice latte because I'm a beautiful butterfly. Oh, I love pumpkin spiced. I love fall. That's when I go in my cocoon.
That was good. That was, it was slightly Kermit-y, but I liked it. All right, next one.
I'm going to keep eating this cranberry sauce.
SpongeBob SquarePants.
Oh, dang. I can actually do that one.
You can do way more than I can. For me, it's just kind of like laughing at which ones I can't do. On a Zoom call with Grandma. Hey! Grandma! Hey! Did you get the cookies I baked? I mean, I got the cookies you baked. The only thing I do is laugh. Ah, remember the episode we were in where you baked cookies for me? Remember that episode?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, my next one. I feel so embarrassed during this segment.
Bob Dylan Buying a turkey at the store. I don't know. Bob, don't.
10-second impressions. Go. You gotta go.
Yeah, I'll take. I'll take a turkey there, man. Yeah, so I'll take that turkey. So I can. I want to S that
T. Matt, did that sound anything like Bob Dylan?
No.
All right, we've got a few more. We've got Jimmy Stewart, who was dead before I was born, or okay. About to eat a pumpkin pie. Well, folks. Well. You know, welcome back to the Tonight Show. I'm Jimmy Stewart, and this is I'm going to eat this delicious pie that my friend, my wife, Martha Stewart, made for me. Jimmy Stewart hosted a late night show, right? Which one? Who am I thinking of?
Okay, all right, let's just keep moving.
Who am I thinking of?
Donald Trump observing the fall colors.
Okay, you know, frankly, I like the orange. I like the yellow. I like the browns. Frankly, probably better than anybody else. I'm probably the biggest fan of fall and fall colors than anybody else. I'm probably the most fall guy that you'll ever meet. Okay?
Not
like Sleepy Joe.
Ellen DeGeneres.
You are like striking.
Baking a pie. What? Well, so I'm sitting there, and I'm putting all the pecans on there, and I say, Portia, come in here, Portia.
So you think you think that Ellen DeGeneres just sounds like you saying Portia? Okay,
this is the worst. I'm not good at it.
Dr. Fauci. This is the saying worst grace. This is the last one.
Okay, wait, saying grace.
Yeah.
Okay.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this bountiful meal, and we thank you that this meal was prepared and that we can eat this meal 6 feet apart, socially distanced, wearing masks between each bite.
That's really bad.
This, I say, was by far worse than the last time we did this.
Well, for you.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, maybe.
This is tough because I don't know if any of these are worth 200 points. But
I think that I had at least
I'm going to have to go with my heart here. And my heart says Heimlich from A Bug's Life.
Yes, that was incredible.
Thank you.
That was incredible.
I do a mean Heimlich.
200 points for you. I want to apologize, I think, to people who are watching because well, you're probably not watching anymore because you're like, why would I watch or listen to this podcast when it's not funny at all? But I promise this next segment is going to be much funnier. Make sure you're eating those cranberries, JJ.
I am like halfway done with the can, Josh, all right?
That brings us to our next segment, which we call the Weekly Uh-Oh.
Now, Josh and I have scoured the interwebs, if you will, and we are always searching for things that people probably shouldn't have posted.
Mm-hmm.
And so we are going to go through our Weekly Uh-Ohs for this week. Our first one comes from Facebook, and Facebook is always just a great place. Now, they have
one of those statuses where they put their status and then put like a photo behind it, or it's like a graphic and it's like in a big square instead of just posting a status. I've really only seen like people 35 and older do this on Facebook, but yeah, that's what we're working with.
It's here. The smileys, and it says, "At this age, I need glasses. ... All caps, wine glasses, period, LOL, wine glass emoji, laughy face, heart.
And then we got a guy named Bruce Rose comments back, Gertrude's cat passed away yesterday evening.
And this is so sad.
I don't understand why he thought this was the proper avenue.
Yeah, Bruce, that's
maybe a DM or a text, Bruce.
Yeah.
I like that one. All right, on to our next one.
Our next one comes from a company,
and this one's from
this one we did some digging. We actually this one is from a while ago, but
yeah, it's from years ago.
Upon our feeds this week.
Someone brought it to our attention. This one makes me sick to read.
It's a tweet from Gap, the clothing company Gap, and it says, I'm laughing, but it's also like
it's horrible.
All impacted by hashtag Sandy. Stay safe. We'll be doing lots of Gap.com shopping today. How about you?
Oh, gosh.
Gap, I love you. Uh-huh. But, you know, maybe read the room a little bit, or, yeah, you know, maybe maybe click on the hashtag,
yeah,
hashtag Sandy. And see.
They're something. Like, oh, Sandy, that sounds like the name of someone who would shop at Gap. No.
Your mom? Does your mom shop at Gap?
Sandy Fossil shops at Gap.
All right, and last but not least, Josh.
Do you mind if I read this one?
Yeah, you go ahead and read this one.
Since I am married, I feel like I should be able to read this one. It says, it's another one of those statuses with a photo behind it. My husband and I are looking for someone to play the harmonica while we have sex. No weirdos, please.
Now, I have a strong feeling that this one is a joke.
Yeah, it could be. Probably is a joke.
But I hope that it's not.
Yeah. And if it's on Facebook and it's real, I don't know what their definition of weirdo is. Because if someone who's willing to be there during boinking, then I classify that as a weirdo. Hey,
I would too.
Hey, call me old-fashioned. but I do think this should probably live, if it's legitimate, on Craigslist.
Yes.
Not on Facebook.
Yeah.
And that has been this week's weekly uh-oh.
So watch what you post, because you might end up in the next one.
JJ and I may make fun of you.
Well, Thanksgiving is right around the corner, mm-hmm, and this holiday is all about being thankful.
I mean, it is. It's in the name. Thanksgiving.
Giving thanks. Mm-hmm. So we are going to our next segment called Give Thanks. You know, we realized, Josh and I, that we should be thankful for everything.
Yeah. So what's happening in this segment is Matt has some things in this hat for us, and we're going to tell you why we are thankful for them. So thank you, Matt, for giving that to us. We'll grab.
I'm so over cranberry sauce right now.
Paperclips. I am thankful for paperclips because there have been so many times where I'm walking with 2, 3, 5, 10 pieces of paper, mm-hmm, where I'm without a paperclip and they just all fall, mm-hmm, on the floor.
I'm thankful for paperclips because, you know, you can unbend them and the port in your phone.
Yes.
You can scrape out the lint that gets stuck in there because sometimes your charger won't plug in all the way. Paperclips are great for that.
That is so smart.
I'm very thankful for
paperclips. If you ever need to get to your SIM card as well, you can, mm-hmm, use that. Let's get to the next one.
Next one. Jellyfish.
Okay, one time, my dad grew up in Spain, and so we went to
España
to visit Spain once, and we found a jellyfish on the beach. And my sister and I, who were probably like 10 and 8 at the time, jumped on it like a trampoline. So I am thankful for jellyfish because they're very bouncy.
I am thankful for jellyfish because of SpongeBob, you know, because,
uh-huh, yep,
jellyfishing. Ah!
Okay, you don't have to do a better impression than I did.
I had to. That was the one thing I had to do.
Okay, next one. Delaware.
I am so thankful for Delaware. It was the which state?
It was the 38th state.
It was in the top 5.
It was
I
one
believe.
Of the first states to be in put in.
I am thankful for Delaware because I used to collect state coins as, mm-hmm, a kid.
Yeah.
And my grandma used to give them to me all the time. I remember Delaware as being really cool. It's George Washington in the boat.
I'm thankful for Delaware, right, because that's where we get the name deli from, right, because they sell a lot of meat there, yeah, right? Second cousins. I am thankful for second cousins because they're one of those type of family members where you never have to see them.
But, you know, when you do see them, it's like, oh, what up? Like, we're kind of related.
Yeah, and you never have to get super deep.
And you don't have to give them a gift. All right, this next one is my wife.
Well, this one's a little more serious. I'm thankful for my wife. Maybe I'll cry. My wife is my partner in life, which I'm thankful for. I'm never lonely because of Brenna. I love doing life with her all the time. You know, it's like, obviously it's the big things like, you know, getting our dogs and celebrating holidays and stuff together. Even like going through like our car is doing horrible things right now, like it's gonna die, and going through the frustrations of life together. But even like the small things, just like hanging out, watching TV, you know, watching her pot her plants. You know, I don't, that's not a euphemism for anything.
She actually pots plants.
My wife loves plants.
You're not a plant.
We have a lot of We have a lot of plants at our apartment. I'm very thankful for her, you know. I love her a lot, and she loves me a lot.
I'm thankful for your wife as well.
Okay, why are you thankful for Brenna?
Because she's your wife.
Uh-huh.
And you're my friend, and I'm happy that you're married.
And I don't know if anybody knows this, JJ was in our wedding.
I was.
I mean, he wasn't like...
I was very far at the end
of
the
line. Yeah,
he
wasn't standing very close to me, but he was near the end.
I was a little offended.
Uh-huh. Okay, we got one more in here. Okay, the last one is each other. Well...
Oh, my gosh.
I mean, I am thankful for JJ because, well, friendships just make life much more spicy, fun.
Invigorating.
Yeah. I don't know if you can tell the podcast, JJ and I are very different people, and I think I've learned a lot from JJ, not just with, like, comedy and acting and stuff like that, but just like different ways to view the world. And JJ, what I'm thankful about JJ, he is, and I don't exaggerate, the most welcoming and inclusive person I've ever met in my entire life.
Gosh.
And people have said this when we were in college, they would be like, they would see JJ. JJ was kind of like famous on our college campus, and JJ would remember people's names that he had only met one time, and they'd be like, "How did that guy remember my name?" And I'm very thankful for JJ and how he treats people, how he loves people. Yeah. So,
well, I'm very thankful for Josh, and I think it's hard in life, I think, sometimes to find people that you could consider a best friend. And Josh,
I'm gonna cry.
I do consider I'm getting a little teary. I do consider you one of my best friends. Like,
I consider you one of my best friends.
Even though
too.
I was very far on the end of the line, I'm just kidding.
But there were so many people who weren't even up there.
I will say also with Josh. Josh is one of the kindest people that I know, and he's also a guy that can get away with saying anything. And it's always very funny. But I mean, Josh, I'm very thankful for the times that we have together when we, you know, make, you know, crazy stuff like this podcast, but also just the, you are somebody who can, you know, have very deep conversations with about life.
We hang out outside the podcast too.
Yes, we do.
We do.
Yes, we do.
So, that is a give thanks. So,
that is give thanks.
I mean, got a little deep there. Which I'm not happy about.
And I'm almost done with this cranberry sauce.
Get one more good bite in there. Get one more good bite. I'm thankful for JJ's big mouth. All right. On this show, you know that we appreciate history. If we don't know what's happened in the past, it's doomed to repeat itself. So we're going to throw it to our buddy, Tat Morey, with This Day in History.
Hey, guys. Happy Thanksgiving from Dallas, Texas. I'm here today because on November 24th, 1963, Jack Ruby shot and killed President John F. Kennedy's suspected assassin, Lee Harvey Oswald, on live TV. I say suspected assassin, of course, because Lee Harvey Oswald was never actually put on trial. However, as we all know from the 2014 documentary Days of Future Past, President John F. Kennedy's actual assassin was a mutant named Magneto.
Tat, hold up. I think, you know, that was a fictional story, right?
Yeah. X-Men, you know, it's a movie about superheroes.
Good one, guys. Next you'll be telling me that, Alex Honnold didn't actually free solo El Capitan, or that Nicolas Cage didn't actually steal the Declaration of Independence.
That's National Treasure.
One of my favorite documentaries. Back to you both in the studio.
Thanks, Tat.
Well, that brings us to the end of our show, to a segment we call Mail Time. Now, Mail Time is going to work a little different this week. Instead of sending something to a friend or family member, tell them what we're doing, JJ.
We are donating $150 to Feeding America.
Now, if you've never heard of Feeding America, they are an organization that's fighting to end hunger in America by providing those in need with meals.
Mm-hmm. And especially due to the effects of the coronavirus, more than 54 million people may experience food insecurity in 2020, and that includes a potential 18 million children.
So if you want to figure out how you could help, we've put the link in our description. You can go there and check their website for ways that you can help.
Well, thank you for joining us for the Thanksgiving episode of your third favorite podcast. We're gonna go run around with some turkeys on our heads.
Yes, we are. We will see you next week.
But,
bye-bye.
I gotta finish this cranberry sauce. Final bite.
And you did finish it, did you?
This is the final
last
bite.
That is empty, folks. That is empty. I'm proud of you, pal.
Thank you. I hate that you won that one.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving. I'm thankful for you.
Thankful for you, too.
I'm thankful for all of you.
JJ, I'm just really thankful for all the people who've been tuning into our videos, watching our stuff, going to our channel.
And I just realized we forgot to ask people to like and subscribe.
Oh gosh, we really have to write that down. How hard is it to remember to tell people to like and subscribe to our channel?
It doesn't even take that long for people to do.
What does it take, like 2 seconds? Like and subscribe.